Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. One of the great things that sets Age of Empires apart from some other real-time strategy games is its random map generation. That means to an extent you have to scout and adapt every game to what the map gives you. Things like how exposed your resources are and how easy it is to wall your base can have a big impact on the course of the game. Now, despite the appearance of randomness and being called random maps, they aren't actually random, and for this video I was wondering what are the odds that at some point you'll play the same map twice. It turns out, depending on how often you mix up your lobby settings, it might be more than you think. Take a guess, if you play or watch 500 1v1 Arabia games, what do you think are the odds of a repeated map? Hang on to that guess and we'll see if you're right. Let's check it out. Just to start with a basic fact, for the original Age of Conquerors CD and on HD, there are 32,768 seeds. That is, with each game, a number is chosen randomly, for all intents and purposes, and that goes into an algorithm that the game uses to generate the map, while also taking into account other programmed features, like resource distribution, clumping of trees, and water. Just to give an example of how the number's used, by playing around with it, I've noticed for Arabia maps, if the fourth digit from the right is a 6, 7, 8, or 9, the map seems to always be green. On the other hand, anything between 1 and 4 usually seems to give a desert map. That's a very simplistic example, but it illustrates the idea that once a number is chosen, the rest of the map is predetermined. It's also chaotic in a mathematical sense, in that a very small change to the starting number results in a completely different looking map. Increasing the seed number by 1 doesn't just move things a few tiles over, it completely rearranges everything. To get slightly more technical for a second, I found a really good random map scripting guide on Age of Kings Heaven, which shows the sort of instructions you give for the map to generate gold piles, cliffs, or anything else. To look at cliffs specifically, you can see that giving it a range of lengths to choose from helps reinforce the appearance of randomness and variety, while at the same time, nothing here is truly random. You can even give minimum distances of features from each other, and I also happen to think it's cute that the cliffs are described by their curliness. Now, why the limit of 32,768? Basically, because that's 2 to the power of 15, and has to do with the fact that the game is 16-bit. Age of Empires only uses positive numbers or 0 for seeds, which means the algorithm won't generate maps with higher numbers. You can make those maps in the editor that would never appear online by manually selecting them, but if it's left to the game, it always picks a number within that range. Over 32,000 possible Arabia maps sounds like a lot, and it's safe to say no one would ever play them all, but we're not done yet. As you increase the map size, it doesn't just scale up the same map, it generates a whole new one. Seed number 15 on a tiny map is completely different than seed 15 on a small map, and so on. Changing the number of players also completely changes the map. Seed 15 on a small map with 2 players is completely different than with 3 players. There are other choices you get to make in starting a game, but as far as I can tell, they don't impact the map generation itself. What is unclear to me is if different game modes, like Regicide or King of the Hill, do a completely new map based on the seed, or if it generates the map normally and then adds the extra castles or monument after. I suspect the unusual features are just added at the end after the generation, but if anyone can confirm one way or the other, I'd be interested to know. Assuming different game modes aren't introducing new map generations, we're looking at 32,768 seeds, times 7 map sizes on HD, times 7 possible numbers of players, which gives us about 1.6 million possible maps. At this point, we're just getting started though. So far, that's only for Arabia, and despite the popular misconception, there are other maps you can play. Classic Age of Conquerors has 23 maps, if we exclude the ES maps, and the expansions have now added 26 more. That leads to a lot of possibilities. If you were to play a quick 20-minute game on every possible map and seed combination included in the expansions, it would take almost 3,000 years to play them all. Now, to be fair, a lot of those combinations don't make any sense. When's the last time someone played Mangrove Jungle on a medium-sized map with 7 players? Probably never. I'd guess the few most common settings are played more often than all the others put together, which could easily put the majority of games being played taken from a pool of about a million maps. But what if you're really picky? Let's say you only play 1v1 Arabia or 4v4 Black Forest. What are your chances of running into the same map twice? To answer that question, let's start by talking about birthdays. Bear with me. Let's say you have two people in a room. What do you think are the odds they'd have the same birthday? Well, about 1 in 365. If the first person is assigned a random birthday by the universe, then the second person would have a 1 in roughly 365 chance of the universe randomly assigning them the same one. In reality, there's a slight chance of being born on a leap day, and some birthdays are more common than others, but for simplicity, we'll say it's about a 1 in 365 chance. The question, also known as the birthday paradox, is how many people do we need in this room until there's a 50% chance that two have the same birthday? Well, we know we have a 100% chance of someone sharing a birthday if we have 366 people, since we run out of days to assign them. So you might think about half of that would be 50%. It turns out though, the real answer is 23 people. That magical event in elementary school where two kids in the class had the same birthday is actually not that amazing in terms of probability. The best way to think of it isn't by trying to add up all the different odds of the possible combinations, but instead by thinking about what are the odds that the same birthday isn't picked twice. With the second person, we had 364 days left to pick from out of 365, so the odds if we chose randomly are 99.7% that we'd get a new one. But now for the third person, we only have 363 days to choose from. As we add more people, the odds of continuing the streak decrease more quickly than our intuition tells us. By the 23rd person, our odds of maintaining that streak of only selecting previously unchosen dates is down to about 50%. The same thing happens with random maps in Age of Empires. Instead of 365 birthdays to choose from, we have 32,768 map seeds. And instead of people in a room being randomly selected birthdays, we have games being played. Our person who always plays the same settings has a small chance of encountering the same map twice in their first two games. But by game 100, they already have a 14% chance of running into a seed twice. By 213 games, it's a 50% chance, with 300 games giving us 75%, and after 500 games, it's about a 97.8% chance they'll have recognized a map at some point. In fact, that was the answer to the question I asked at the start of the video, and are the odds you'll see a map repeat if you watch or play 500 1v1 Arabia games. Now that's not to say everyone has definitely replayed the same map if they've logged 1,000 games or more. The odds go way down if you split your time between different settings. For instance, with 200 games of one setting, you have a 46% chance of encountering one twice. But if you split your time between two maps with 100 games each, it's only a 26% chance. The same seed might come up, but you won't recognize it unless everything was set the same way at the start. To extend it, if you have 10 favorite map settings you play 20 times each, it's the same total number of games, but only a 5.6% chance of replaying a map. So the odds are pretty good that you'll eventually repeat a map if you always play the same settings. But for most people who mix it up, while it's likely you've encountered the same seed, it's unlikely you've had the same settings, and therefore the same map. That being said though, with as many people playing as there are, it's probably a regular occurrence. And most of the maps with the most common settings have probably been played at this point. There's no official data on it, but I would conservatively estimate there are at least 100 1v1 Arabia games being played every day on Steam. That's only 4 an hour, and here you can see I filtered for Arabia, and there's 4 already waiting in the lobby to start. Assuming that holds, we'd expect roughly every 2 days on average for the same map to show up for different people. In reality, it's probably way more likely than that, considering this was just for 1v1 Arabia. 3v3 Black Forest is even more popular. It's also hard to say how close to random the seed generation is, and the odds would be better if it preferred certain numbers or tends to repeat some of them, which is a common problem in a lot of pseudo-random number generators. Now I should point out that things are a bit different on Voobly, which has many more map seeds. I'd love to show the math, but I haven't found an online calculator yet which can handle the insanely large factorials. Voobly claims to have over 4 billion unique seeds for each map, as opposed to the old Age of Conquers and HD versions, roughly 33,000. Though it's hard to say how different some of those maps would be from each other, or how randomly they're chosen. There are claims out there, even on Voobly, of the same map showing up twice, and that might either reveal some sort of bias in the random generation, or it could truly be random. With enough time and thousands of games played, even with 4 billion seeds, you would expect the same maps to pop up now and then. And I think that's the most interesting part. It's human nature to think very unlikely events will never happen, especially to us. But if you give unlikely events enough opportunity, those unlikely events actually become probable, and even inevitable. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.